Ronda Rousey.
Former UFC star.
Ronda wants to make it happen quickly.
Now she gave
There's the arm. She gave
it is all over.
Former UFC non-star. WWE star.
Rousey not letting go.
And now Mortal Kombat voiceover star person. However, some video gamers have a problem with this. They're attacking Ronda Rousey for having a job. This Kotaku article, Ronda Rousey being in Mortal Kombat 11 is bullshit. Now you know you're in for some objective, cutting-edge journalism when they can't even write the title without swearing in it. Now I'm not even a huge Ronda Rousey fan. I prefer WWE Wrestling Ronda to UFC Ronda. So if this article was going to go on about how she's not good at her job or she's a bad voice actress, I might actually jump on board here. But don't you have an inkling feeling that that wasn't exactly the case? Let's see what the article says. Ronda shared an inflammatory conspiracy video about the 2012 Sandy Hook massacre to her millions of Twitter followers and made transmisogynistic and outright asinine comments about transgender MMA fighter Fallon Fox. Transmisogynistic is a new one for even me, believe it. Quoting Ronda saying, I just figure asking questions and doing research is more patriotic than blindly accepting what you're told, she said in a reply on Twitter. The following day, she made another tweet saying that, quote, never meant to hurt or insult anyone, and that she was, quote, sorry if anyone was offended. What a monster, Ronda Rousey. Fox is the first openly transgender MMA fighter in the sport's history. She had undergone sex reassignment surgery in 2006, but received pushback against the idea that she could fight against other women. So far we're saying that Ronda pretty much shouldn't have a job because she retweeted a conspiracy theory 7 years ago and disagrees that an MMA fighter who was a man for 30 years shouldn't be able to fight against women in the sport who are clearly, as the science shows, at a physical disadvantage. Now this is kind of an old argument given how long ago Fallon Fox actually was in the news, and it's likely that the author here, Heather Alexandra, real name I'm sure, doesn't actually know what's going on with the issue and just saw disagrees with transgendered person and blew their f***ing lid.
But have you been mobbed before? You have.
Oh yeah!
What's been the worst?
Oh, one of the big ones was about a trans fighter.
I remember that.
Yeah, that was a hilarious one.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, you guys can kiss my fucking ass. You're out of your mind. You guys are out of your mind if you think that a man who has been a man for 30 years and has taken female hormones for 2 is the same.
Mm-hmm.
You put Brock Lesnar, chop his dick off and put him in a dress. That guy's going to maul through the women's heavyweight division like nothing you've ever seen in your life.
Yeah.
Because we're built different. And yeah. It's just a fact. And anyone who tries to argue that is crazy. And there's certainly standouts in terms of women who are much more muscular, higher bone density, particularly African-American women, a very high bone density. But there's a different shape to their hips. There's the size of the hands, the size of the shoulders. Things are different.
Mm-hmm.
And also the imprinting of years and years of testosterone. It's just, there was a great article by this board-certified endocrinologist who went over all the things that separate men from women, which should exclude them from competing in combat sports against women. And this woman was called a transphobe, and I mean, she's a fucking endocrinologist, you idiot. She's talking about the science. And she's also talking about the science of, one of the things they talk about is how women, you know, or trans woman, once they transition to being a woman, they're basically biologically almost exactly the same as a woman. She was like, no. Not only that, but the bone density is retained by taking estrogen, which is what the problem with women when they have osteoporosis is they're losing estrogen, they lose bone mass. Well, the estrogen actually helps you retain bone mass. Mm-hmm. So when a man transitions to a woman and then starts taking estrogen, it's actually helping retain the bone mass that he would have lost by not having testosterone.
Mm-hmm.
And then on top of that, reaction times, reaction times are several tenths of a second faster in general for women than they are for men rather than they are for even professional athlete women. Mm-hmm. So all these all these variables
yeah.
that need to be taken into consideration when you're allowing someone to do a sport. And we're not just talking about bike racing. We're not talking about, you know, something where someone...
Non-contact.
Yeah, we're talking about the most contact. We're talking about fucking fighting.
The article goes on to quote Ronda again and also uses comments from heavyweight Matt Mitrione, who has commented for making some pretty harsh remarks about Falcon Fox in an obvious attempt to show how much bigotry and hate there is in the sport of MMA because Ronda didn't think that Mitrione should have been suspended for his comments. Of course, the problem here is that Ronda was actually correct, and there is data to back this up, as Joe Rogan spoke about. Bone density, hip positioning, muscle mass, muscle reaction time. A lot of things, believe it or not, go into the reasons as to why men are naturally stronger than women, if you can even wrap your head around that possibility. You see, when someone lives 30 years as a man and then transitions, they don't just magically lose their frame and their bone structure and all their muscle mass that years of testosterone pumping into their system gives them. It's actually not a knock on transgenderism or transgendered people at all. It's just about fairness and about biology, really, and the fact that we need to bottle feed this information to people so that they don't freak out irrationally is really sad. Now, I made the grave mistake of making these comments on the Facebook page for a video game channel called Video Game Sophistry, a very ironic name, mind you. This is where I saw the article, so I commented these things on it. And what I did not expect from a gaming channel was the insane ramblings that I got. I basically said in the post everything I've already said, that the author of this article wants to fire Ronda Rousey for a retweet and disagreeing with the issue of transgendered fighting in MMA, and not just a blanket statement against transgendered people as a whole. And of course, that was completely unacceptable, even though I'm not alone in this, Ronda's not alone in this. The people who have fought Fallon Fox are against her fighting. Here's a video of one of her opponents who didn't even know that she used to be a man before she fought her.
Why do you think that that's important for you or any other opponent of Fox's to know?
So we are aware and be able to be better prepared for the situation.
What do you think you need to be better prepared for?
Well, just knowing that, you know, the... Help me here.
she's trying to say is just knowing that what you're getting into, you know, not having any disclosure of something of that nature, you know, it puts a lot of stress after the fight, obviously, you know, as this story's breaking. But, you know, it's something that the managers know that they should disclose, and in which they didn't.
Another woman who fought Fallon Fox was Ashley Evans Smith. Now, I'm pretty familiar with Ashley. She's quite a nice person, and even though she beat her, she agrees that she shouldn't be fighting other women because of the clear advantage that the years of testosterone has.
Like, do you feel, you know, that she should be able to still compete then against women? I mean, do you feel like that's fair?
You know, everyone kind of mistook my fighting Fallon as me saying, hey, Fallon should be allowed to fight women. But honestly, it was just a unique situation where, like I said, I had just entered the tournament, or had already been in the tournament, and then she came out, you know, and I felt, you know what, this is my money, this is my title, and I'm not going to pull out for anything. Given that, I really feel like there should be a transgender organization, you know. I don't feel like Fallon should fight dudes. I don't feel like she should fight women. I feel like there should be a unique organization for those needs, you know? She did have an advantage. She definitely did. But I took the fight knowing that. And not every woman wants to go into a fight with the advantage. If someone asked me today, would you like to fight Fallon for one fight contract with this amount of money, I would say no. Because I want to fight someone, and I think all other women want to fight someone that were born on the same playing field, an equal playing field. So I'm, you know, and I... Part of me is sorry to say this, you know, and I hope the LGBT community does not take this the wrong way. I just feel like there's too much of an advantage for her to fight against women.
So after I made my biologically backed up argument, I was met with this response. We are a progressive video game channel that believes in humanity in gaming. If you disagree with that, please go and die. It seems very tolerant. It's pretty tolerant for a person who's progressive. So I replied with this. It's hilarious that your channel takes a political stance. Not smart, but hilarious. More importantly, it seems you know nothing about the issue. Fallon Fox was a man till 30, then transitioned to a woman. I have no problem with that. The issue is that she already had the muscle mass and bone density that 30 years of testosterone gives you, giving her a huge advantage, resulting in her seriously injuring women when fighting against them, and not just by pure skill. If you really were progressive, you would be against the idea of taking work away from a woman, simply for having an opinion on a complex issue, as well as retweeting something once. I think my comments were pretty fair there, considering they don't seem to be showing any knowledge of the actual topic, like the fact that Fallon Fox actually cracked a woman's skull before, and they're just trying to blanket this as a bigoted statement for anyone who challenges the idea that she should be able to fight other women. Now, to my surprise, my comment was actually deleted, so therefore the reply was deleted as well, but I was able to take that from a copy and paste that I sent to my friend because after I saw the article, I was discussing it with him. But in case you don't believe me, here's a screen grab of another person who didn't much care for the take, this hot, very, very hot take, and you can see the type of people running this channel by the way they reply to people. From what I got from this complainer is that I don't like her opinions on politics, so F her and she shouldn't be able to be the voice actress for Sonya in Mortal Kombat. Seriously, she did an amazing job and breathed new and fresh life into an old and beloved character. All the voice actors did phenomenally with the characters. I've been a Mortal Kombat fan for many years and the story was the best one yet. Hell, it was better than most games centered around stories, and this is a fighting game. To which they replied, "This story is one of the best ones yet, but this particular voice actress, notice they won't even say her name, is an effing nut job. She was brought in because of her celebrity status and is crazy. I'd much rather have an accomplished, talented, actual voiceover actor, like the other characters had, than a washed-up MF-er who thinks the Sandy Hook massacre was fake and doesn't understand what trans issues are." Now you kind of see the type of people that are running this channel. They are very standoffish against anyone who disagrees with them, and they're very quick to label anyone they disagree with on a complex topic such as trans issues in athletics from male to female. And they're willing to label these people as crazy and terrible just for having a simple disagreement, which the other person's actually right on, biologically speaking. Of all places, I didn't really expect to find the blind cultism in the world of video game analysis, so I was pretty surprised, I gotta say. These are the type of people that you would find at one of those protest videos where they just try to shout you down and call you horrible names, which I've been a part of. The ones that'll show up and put a sign in your face and call you a fascist or a Nazi. From what I've shown you, this is not the type of person that wants to have a conversation with you or even change your mind, even on their business page. Disagreeing with them just makes them spiral out of control and label you as all these sorts of things and petition for you to lose your job. The irony here that I've left for the end is the actual definition of sophistry, which they use in their name, which is the use of fallacious arguments, especially with the intention of deceiving. So, huge troll? No, it's sadly, it's not. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, because YouTube hates me. They like to take away subscribers. I've seen video counts go down. Go ahead and try to send me some money on Patreon. I'd really appreciate it. Maybe some foot photos. And This Is Andrew Says, I wouldn't lie to you. Except for maybe this once. You ever seen Rhonda's shadow box? It's like she's flailing noodles.